So I want to soil test my swamp, because who wouldn't want to soil test their swamp? But I don't want to disturb the soil. It's very sensitive habitat, and like every invasive species on the face of the planet wants to take it over. So I don't want to, be careful about, what is that? It's a pine warbler. So I'm going to do the poor man's soil test, which is to find some plants and figure out how to grow them, and that will tell me what the soil is like. This is red trillium, which prefers acidic, sandy, rich soil. This is pagoda dogwood, which likes rich, sandy, acidic soil. This one is Solomon's bloom, which prefers rich, sandy, acidic soil. This one is Jack in the Pulpit, which prefers rich, sandy, acidic soil. Swamp, your wood thrushes are back. You can stop sulking now. I think that my swamp has rich, sandy, acidic soil. So say I was going through some midlife crisis and I decided that I wanted to stop growing vegetables in my garden and I wanted to grow a swamp instead. The main thing I would need to focus on is lowering my pH. I already have all the nutrients, but I have a nice middle ground pH, which is suitable for vegetables, but not as friendly to these various plants that I would want to grow in this hypothetical situation. Some real life clues that I have in my garden that I'm aware of is dandelions, which indicates that it's a sign that my soil is low in calcium, which I know to be true. I always have to add calcium so that my peppers don't get blossom end rot, for example. And I have this patch in my yard that is always getting taken over by red sorrel. The red sorrel growing over there and nothing else is a sign that my soil over there is highly acidic and it has no nutrients. The soil over there is actually very much like what my garden used to be like when I very first started it. So yeah, try this at home if you don't feel like getting a soil test. It's a lot more fun than trying to interpret vague shades on a home test, and it's free. And it will tell you basically the same information.